Hello everybody, assalamu alaikum. This is Fiza Farhan. I am an advisor to the UN Secretary General. I am a working woman. I am the convener of the Male Champions of Change program in Pakistan. And sabse barki, I think I'm a woman. And that's why having being here today and having this conversation today is very, very important to me. To begin the conversation with all these wonderful guests that we have today, I think I would like to start with the elephant in the room. When we're talking about women's empowerment, so why do we have only men on this panel, right? And this is a question which comes to me very, very often, being the convener of the Male Champions of Change program in Pakistan, that you're talking about women's empowerment, you're talking about gender equality, but you're talking about you have only men to work on this very important agenda, and we're the women. So, सबसे पहले, I think इस चीज की बात कर लेते हैं कि why do we need men to step up for women's empowerment? So, we're going to have a fun conversation today. I would love to hear your views, your opinions. You guys are walking, talking champions of change. And this conversation is going to be about influencing, inspiring, and empowering more men out there to become male allies like you. So, my first question, and we're going to have a conversation. So, जिसको पहले जवाब देना हो, please jump in. My first question to you guys will be, जिस तरह I have personally experienced being a woman, जिसने different roles करते करते यहाँ तक पहुँची हूँ, I have seen how over these years and over these two decades, the agenda of women's empowerment and gender equality has transitioned globally and in Pakistan from being a feminist issue, a human rights issue, a social agenda to becoming a business case, जैसे मैंने पहले कहा. आप अपनी personal example से please tell me that when was that moment for you? When was that tipping point for you guys? When did you experience this transition, realizing that women's empowerment is not just the right thing to do, but it is the smart thing to do? So your personal tipping point is what I want to hear from you. So Amit, would you like to go first?
Yeah, I can. I think so. Thank you, Fiza, for really setting the context. Mere khayal mein wo debate over ho gayi hai ki ye ek social cause hai ya ek commercial cause hai. It's clearly a commercial cause. और पर्टिकुलरली फ्रॉम अ यूनिलीवर पर्सपेक्टिव हम जो प्रोडक्ट बेचते हैं उनमें से 95% जो कंज्यूमर है वो ख़वातीन है एंड सेलिंग अ प्रोडक्ट टू वुमेन एंड नॉट रियली अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड नोइंग देयर साइकी यू कैन नॉट बी अ ग्रेट मार्केटर सो देयरफॉर इट वाज इम्पॉर्टेंट के ऑन द टेबल हमारे पास ख़वातीन हो जो कि उनका पर्सपेक्टिव लेकर आएँ उनका पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू लेकर आएँ एक डाइवर्स ओपिनियन लेकर आएँ और जब डाइवर्स ओपिनियन आ रहा है एक उनका अपना पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू आ रहा है देन वी रियलाइज दैट द कॉन्वर्सेशन इज अ लॉट मोर रिचर अ लॉट मोर इनसाइटफुल एंड द सॉल्यूशनिंग इज अ लॉट मोर पावरफुल सो एंड व्हेन फॉर एनी प्राइवेट सेक्टर इट्स ऑल अबाउट विनिंग इन द मार्केट प्लेस यू कैन ओनली विन इन द मार्केट प्लेस व्हेन द ओपिनियंस द इनसाइट्स the point of views you get are very diverse so it's very critical for a woman to have a seat on the table to really contribute and I think that's what the commercial ideation is all around
and when your customer is both men and women and more women than men more. You need to obviously get into their brains and their psyche to be able to sell them,
correct,
right? It's a business case
yeah
absolutely
and I totally agree with Amir because just like Unilever even our products most of our consumers are women right तो जब तक हम उनका पर्सपेक्टिव नहीं समझ रहे थे तो देर वॉज अ प्रॉब्लम राइट वी हैड टू गो आउट एंड गेट दैट पर्सपेक्टिव और वो उतना क्लियरली आ नहीं पा रहा था सो आई एग्री आई थिंक इट्स डेफिनेटली अ बिजनेस इम्पेरेटिव नाउ एंड इवन अगर आप बिजनेस से थोड़ा आगे जाएं आई थिंक इट्स अ नेशनल इम्पेरेटिव क्योंकि अगर आज अगर हम देखें हमारा वीमेन पार्टिसिपेशन इन द वर्क फोर्स इज वेरी वेरी लो द लोएस्ट इन साउथ एशिया वन ऑफ द लोएस्ट इन द वर्ल्ड और जब एंड विद द पॉपुलेशन साइज दैट वी हैव एंड 49% बींग वेमेन अगर आप वो वेमेन पार्टिसिपेशन वर्कफोर्स में नहीं बढ़ाएंगे तो हाउ विल द कंट्री प्रॉस्पर राइट इट्स नॉट जस्ट अबाउट द कंपनीज कंपनीज तो करेंगी इंशाल्लाह वो सारे कर रहे हैं आई थिंक इट्स मोर देन अ बिजनेस केस इट्स अ नेशनल इशू नाउ और अगर हम पाकिस्तानी कॉन्टेक्स में बात करें डिपेंडिंग ऑन हुज नंबर यू बिलीव वेमेन पार्टिसिपेशन इज एनी वेयर बिटवीन 22-24% बट ऑफ दैट 22-24% ऑलमोस्ट 70% आर इन एग्रीकल्चर
No, like what Amir and Umar has said. So, clearly, as an organization, we firmly believe that diversity, inclusivity, and empowerment is a superpower that fuels the innovation and growth in an organization. And to the same point, when you have a diverse ओपिनियन आपकी टेबल पे अवेलेबल होता है सो यू गेट डिफरेंट पर्सपेक्टिव्स राइट सो एंड यू गेट वी नीड टू रिमेंबर दैट 50% ऑफ अ पॉपुलेशन इज कंप्राइज्ड ऑफ फीमेल राइट सो इफ यू ओवरलुक देयर पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू योर देयर ओपिनियंस you'll never be able to come to a sensible conclusion.
Established out and loud that it's a business case, 100%. Achha, now I would like to talk to you guys about something with your personal journeys, right? We're very blessed to have all of you here. And you know, you've all had your own personal journeys of professional success. I would like to put it that way. Jabbi, in the journey of professional success, there are lots of enablers that help you, right? As you grow to the top. मेरा हमेशा से एक चैलेंज रहा है बिकॉज व्हेन एवर आई एनालाइज्ड सिचुएशंस ऑफ वुमेन ग्रोइंग इन द प्रोफेशनल ट्रैजेक्टरी वर्सेस मेन ग्रोइंग इन द प्रोफेशनल ट्रैजेक्टरी वी ऑल नो लॉट्स ऑफ वुमेन कम इनटू द वर्क स्पेस बट ड्यूरिंग द मिडिल मैनेजमेंट द हायर मैनेजमेंट दे कीप ऑन गोइंग एंड दे कीप ऑन गेटिंग स्क्यूड एट द टॉप सो व्हाट वर द इनेबलर्स दैट मेड यू इन योर प्रोफेशनल जर्नी गेट टू द टॉप व्हाट वर द की इंडिकेटर्स व्हाट वर द की इनेबलर्स दैट हेल्प्ड यू ग्रो And do you feel that women around you in your organization or in the larger workspace have those enablers or do not have those enablers? So let's talk about your enablers first and then let's try to see how can we get women those enablers so that it's an equal race to the top.
So let me take that first. Mm-hmm. So if I look at my journey, so I've been now working for more than 3 decades, right? So it's been a very long journey. So when I try to boil it down to try and understand if I have to pick one or two key enablers, I think one would be very strong mentorship that I got over the years. And second would be very strong professional networks.
Very strong professional?
Networks. Right? A problem kya hota hai? Ke agar ye do cheeze missing, main apne pure career mein se, 33, 34 years mein se, agar main do ko nikal dun, to meri nazar mein, I might not have achieved what I've achieved, right? And because I realized this, so we in our organization at least, we try to create an environment where the women who work with us are getting those opportunities. So starting maybe, I think it was sometime last year or the year before, I remember our HR team coming to me and asking me, Kaji, Women's Day aa raha hai, kya kare? So I said, Women's Day aa raha hai, but why is that one day so important for you and why not the entire year, right? So they all looked at me, kya baat kar rahe, right? So they'd come up with a beautiful plan, pura din ye karenge, and I just said, I'm not interested, why one day? So that's when we started this journey. We came up with this program which we branded Grit to Great. Aur usme humne pura ek saal ki journey design ki for about more than 100 women that work with us. एंड फिर हमने उसको हमने जो नाम दिया वो था मशल टॉर्च बिकॉज वी आर अ टर्किश कंपनी मशल हैज द सेम मीनिंग इन बोथ लैंग्वेजेस सो व्हाट वी वांटेड दीज 100 वुमेन टू डू वाज टू गो थ्रू दैट प्रोग्राम एंड आई विल टेल यू व्हाट इट वाज एंड देन बिकम द मशलेरा फॉर द रेस्ट ऑफ द वुमेन दैट दे इंटरेक्ट विद द चैंपियंस राइट एंड टू मेक इट सक्सेस हमने उसमें हमारे जो 8 चैंपियंस ऑफ चेंज बनाए उस वक्त आई वाज़न्ट पार्ट ऑफ योर कोलिशन And eight because we have 8 directors.
Okay, good.
So we made, and all of them are men. So we made these 8 directors, the champions of change. And then they led this program from the front.
Excellent.
They provided mentorship opportunities. They created networking opportunities. They created a lot of training and development opportunities. So us pure ek saal ki journey mein, we created both these things that I talked about, which was mentorship. And we created a very strong network of these 100 women जो एक दूसरे को सपोर्ट भी कर रही हैं
नेटवर्क
भी बन गया उनका एंड नाउ दे बिकम द मशल फॉर स्प्रेडिंग इट थ्रू आउट द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन
ओके गाइस आई नो दिस कन्वर्सेशन इज सुपर फन बट आई थिंक इट्स गोना बी टाइम फॉर अ ब्रेक सो लेट्स जस्ट टेक अ स्मॉल ब्रेक एंड वी विल रिज्यूम राइट आफ्टर Welcome back, everybody, and I hope you guys are having as much fun in this conversation as I am. Equity ki baat ho rahi hai, toh phir Unilever se toh sunna padega, because I know that's one of your key ethos.
No, mere khayal mein jo sawal hai, mere khayal mein thoda sa uski zara ground roots pe jaane ki zaroorat hai. कि ऐसा क्यों है कि जो मर्द हज़रात हैं उनको अच्छा पाथ मिल जाता है और ख़वातीन को नहीं मिल पाता मेरे ख्याल में ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में तो जब तक पहुँचेंगी और ऑर्गेनाइजेशन जो करेंगी वो तो बात की बात है मेरे ख्याल में प्रॉब्लम है पाइपलाइन बिल्डिंग का पाइपलाइन आपके पास नहीं है क्योंकि हमारी जो सोसाइटी है वो मेल सेंट्रिक है, बहुत ही पैट्रियार्कल सोसाइटी है. तो जो जब एक लड़का एक लड़की पैदा होता है तो उस वक्त से ही रोल जो है सेगमेंट या असाइन हो जाते हैं. जो एक लड़का होता है उसका रोल असाइन किया जाता है कि जी आप ब्रेड अर्नर हैं, आपने अच्छी सैलरी कमानी है, आपने अच्छा ग्रेड्स लेने हैं और आपको घर के कामों से बिल्कुल रिलीव कर दिया जाएगा. और जो एक लड़की होती है, इवन बेसिकली मॉडर्न घर के अंदर, एक बेसिकली जो प्रोग्रेसिव घर है उसके लिए एक अलग रोल असाइन किया जाता है कि तुम डॉक्टर बन जाओ या तुम बेसिकली यू नो तुम टीचर बन जाओ या तुम प्रोफेसर बन जाओ, ठीक है, जो कन्वेंशनल रोल्स होते हैं. तो उस वक्त से जो नैरेटिव मैनेजमेंट हो रही होती है वो नैरेटिव मैनेजमेंट आपके जो जो आपको जो प्रोसेसिंग हो रही होती है वो डिफरेंट होती है एक लड़के के लिए एक लड़की के लिए. एंड आई थिंक सो दैट्स वेयर द डिफरेंस इज. एंड देयरफॉर जब पाइपलाइन बिल्ड हो रही होती है तो ज़्यादातर खवातीन नहीं आ पाती. अच्छा, जब बाय द टाइम वो आ भी जाती हैं और आप पूरा नेटवर्क बिल्ड भी कर रहे हैं, इट्स टू लेट इन द स्टेज. And I think so that is missing. So the part that is being carved out for men, that's not being carved out for women. काफ़ी ऐसे roles जो हैं जो कि ख़वातीन के लिए write off हुए हुए होते हैं कि आप सेल्स में काम नहीं कर सकती, आप मिलिट्री में काम नहीं कर सकती, आप practically strenuous labor काम नहीं कर सकती, आप फैक्ट्रीज में काम नहीं कर सकती. तो बहुत ही सेगमेंटेशन हो गई है रोल्स की. तो इसकी वजह से फॉर एग्ज़ाम्पल मेरे लिए तो बहुत आसानी थी कि यार मेरे लिए बड़े क्लियर रोल सेगमेंटेड थे, मेरी नैरेटिव मैनेजमेंट उसी तरह की गई थी. उसके बाद जब मैं बेसिकली पढ़ना शुरू किया ऑटोमेटिकली जो है आई हैड रोल मॉडल्स अवेलेबल, प्रोफेशनल नेटवर्क अवेलेबल था. सो आई स्टार्टेड वॉकिंग दैट पाथ. जो अब हमें करने की ज़रूरत है वो ये है कि द मेल हैज़ टू एक्चुअली क्रिएट दैट पाथ फॉर वुमेन फ्रॉम द वेरी बिगिनिंग, नॉट इन द ऑफिस. चलने ठीक है, कर रहे हैं, हम करते रहेंगे. मैं ख्याल में बहुत आगे जा चुकी होगी. आपको प्रैक्टिकली बिल्कुल ग्रास रूट लेवल के ऊपर काम करने की जरूरत है इफ़ यू वॉन्ट women to come and compete on merit
and normalize all of this, right? Yeah. So that equal playing field for men and women.
And that is why the word equity becomes more important.
Exactly.
Because equality mein problem aa jata hai.
Exactly.
I think. Absolutely. So it is the equity which needs to be created and that's what needs to be understood.
Notion also that women's empowerment in some way is to like take a place from a man and then put women on top. No, it's not. It's to empower men and women together as for their potential.
And I think it's like putting spotlight on them and making them more conscious ke jo hai wo agar unko kuch cheez merit pe bhi mili hai, it's questionable ke acha kyunki wo usme char mard to select ho chuke the, ek ab khawatin khatun nahi karni thi, is wajah se selection hua hai. So I think isko hatana chahiye. Aur I think it's a lot to do with programming. Jis tarah Amir ne kaha ke office environment mein to bahut late wo aate hain, pehle jo ghar se shuru hota hai ki usme bhi agar koi बच्ची या कोई लड़की अगर अच्छी तरह काम कर रही है, अच्छा परफॉर्म कर रही है या बहुत रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी के साथ जॉब कर रही है और ये वाली जॉब्स नहीं कर रही कि वो सिर्फ मॉर्निंग में जाके टीचिंग करके घर आ रही है, घर की रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी कर रही है, अगर वो प्रोफेशनली काम कर रही है तो एक जो वर्ड यूज़ किया जाता है कि इसने बेटा बन के दिखाया है या ये तो हमारे बेटे की जैसी है, मतलब आई थिंक इन चीज़ों से भी थोड़ा सा अवॉइड करना चाहिए और घर से ही प्रोग्रामिंग इस तरह से करनी चाहिए कि मतलब वो अगर बेटी भी है तो मतलब शी कैन इक्वली बी रिस्पॉन्सिबल एंड वर्क 9 to 5. आई मीन शी डज नॉट हैव टू वर्क इन एनवायरनमेंट के जहाँ से उसे टीचिंग करनी है, ट्यूशन पढ़ाना है या जो है मतलब इस तरह की कोई जॉब करनी है. तो आई थिंक इट हैज़ टू स्टार्ट लाइक वेरी अर्ली ऑन.
यस,
आई थिंक इसमें आमिर हैज़ इनिशिएटेड वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक. पर्सनली लेट्स से अगर मैं अपनी जर्नी देखूँ, सो आई थिंक देयर आर थ्री फैक्टर्स व्हिच आई वुड से जिन्होंने मुझे सपोर्ट किया, बहुत सारे और भी होंगे, बट आई थिंक द फर्स्ट बीइंग फैमिली सपोर्ट जिस तरह सारे बात की. सेकंड थिंग व्हिच अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल डोंट सी इज एक्सेस टू एजुकेशन, राइट? तो अगर हम बिल्कुल बेसिक लेवल पे चले जाए, सो आज लेट्स से पाकिस्तान की अगर हम बात करें ना, सो विमेन एनरोलमेंट, नेट एनरोलमेंट इज 49% लेस than men. Or literacy there 47% there females ki Pakistan mein and male ki 71%. So such huge disparity. So I think ek pehli cheez which has really supported us is the access to education. And then of course role models. So agar aap hum 10 saal pehle chale jaye, so you would hardly see any role models, female role models especially. Agar hoti bhi thi to unki media projection nahi thi, unki itni zyada visibility nahi thi. So I personally think these are three things which are very very important. And jo Amir ne jisme baat ki na ki by the time bachcha paida hota hai till you know reaches a certain level, ye funnel hai pura. Funnel pe har step pe leakage hai. So bachcha paida hua, perception bana di ki acha PT doctor banenge, and access to education bhi nahi mili. Agar mil bhi gayi to 50% to waisi job mein nahi aayengi, shaadi ho gayi. Agar 50% aap unme se thodi bahut aage job mein bhi aa gayi to career ladder mein leakages hain. So at ye pure funnel mein at different stages there's a lot of leakages for females, unfortunately.
Yeah.
But the good thing is that I think a lot of companies, like Unilever, many other companies, they've started realizing this.
Yeah.
And I think, again, hats off to you as well, because this forum to do, we can make a huge impact across Pakistan.
Okay, guys, so it's time to take a break and we'll resume shortly after because I don't want to miss out on any of this fun conversation. Okay, guys, so I don't know about all of you, but I'm really enjoying this conversation. Very sorry that one of our dear esteemed guests had to leave for a very important meeting. But nevertheless, I'm very happy to conclude this very meaningful, I think, conversation jo honi chahiye, jo mard hazrat ko bhi karni chahiye, auraton ke saath karni chahiye, auraton ke liye karni chahiye. So I'm very happy to conclude it on a very strong note for what we should be now doing at a national level. So my concluding question to all of you will be ke policy level pe ya national level pe what role can you or leaders like you play to influence the policy or to create national messaging and national advocacy for this important imperative, I think, of empowering our women and girls and for enabling the men and the women to collectively step up for this agenda.
No, it's a very important one, and I, as a leader with powers with you, and that's a very important question. And I think one of the greatest powers that we have as leaders is the power of our brand, you know, being household brands, and these brands are present in millions of households. What can we do through the advocacy of our brand? So I'll share one of the experience that we have went through. Humne last year, so Cadbury, jo hamara chocolate ka flagship brand hai.
It's a household name.
It's a household name, or it is about inspiring goodness in Pakistan through different narratives. Mm. And then we said, you know, we want to become the part of the nation's fabric cricket, because we wanted to. We had a business objective around it in terms of driving deeper reach and messaging of our brand to the masses. So we came up with a campaign.
Okay.
And we said that we are going to create role model for the girls in Pakistan cricket ke liye. We put all the 11 players of Pakistani cricketers, women cricketer, on a packaging.
On the packaging of
a chocolate? On the packaging of a chocolate, millions of pack, printed and being distributed across the country, one. And we wanted this journey to be an inclusive one. So when we started working on our communication, so in the communication, the lead role was played by a father who's encouraging his daughter to go and participate and play cricket.
Yeah.
We brought in the male cricketers advocacy as well, and Haris Rauf became our brand ambassador as well. We did this entire campaign at the time when the men's World Cup was going on.
Okay.
So we did this campaign when the men's World Cup was going on last year. We did not stop there. We said, you know, this should be a long-term commitment by a brand to the cause. So now we are the sponsors of Pakistan women cricket team as well, because they don't get the enough financial resources as the men's cricket does. And then now we are also training the number has now reached to about 300 girls in professional cricket academies for the rest of the year. So it's a 1 year program whereby they're going to be trained in a professional academy, and the Pakistani women cricketers would also come, and they'll also advise them on how to play. So we received over 4,000-5,000 entries.
Achha.
By girls across the country, and now they are being trained as well. So as a leader, I think it's very, very important to see, and you know, we have been talking about the shifts and changes that should come in our society from a thinking perspective. But what can we do is a question that we should ask ourselves, and I'm sure there would be many other examples, and how do we action it.
Absolutely. And I love the idea, because I think cricket is in our blood, and anything that links up to cricket, everybody sees, everybody feels, and the message gets through. Cricket and chocolate, how better can it get? The message has to come through. But that's fantastic. I think these are the kind of examples we need to share more, so that we can really change the mindset, and putting it up on men's cricket World Cup ke duran, I think that's beautiful, because that's also, and using the father example of male allyship in the campaign, I think you're checking all the right boxes. Yeah. So great. Zeeshan, please, any thoughts from you?
So I think for me, to your question, I think isko main two parts mein I'll divide. Ek ko national policy level pe, government level pe kya ho sakte hai, and then of course what are we doing in our professional capacities. सो आई थिंक अगर अगेन एज आई सेड अगर 135th पोजिशन है इन द आउट ऑफ 162 इन द ग्लोबल इंडेक्स जेंडर इंडेक्स सो दैट मीन्स समथिंग हैज़ टू बी फंडामेंटली डिफरेंट सो आई थिंक आई विल स्टार्ट ऑफ विद पहली चीज़ तो ये कि फ्रॉम अ गवर्नमेंट लेवल फ्रॉम अ पॉलिसी लेवल सो गवर्नमेंट में भी अगर देखें लेट्स से लेट्स टॉक अबाउट पार्लियामेंट पार्लियामेंट में 20% फीमेल रिप्रेजेंटेशन है ग्रेट जॉब दे हैव डन रियली वेल इन रीसेंट टाइम्स बट अगेन 50% तो फीमेल्स है ना पाकिस्तान में सो अगेन ऑन दैट फ्रंट सो देर हैज़ टू बी वेरी क्लियर drive and policy on the government front as well, just pay actively they're working on that as well. Yeah, now coming towards Syngenta, I think we realized ki ek to zahir hai internal apne jo female colleagues hain unke liye we're doing a lot of things many other companies are doing very good. So I think usme I'll not talk touch upon that, but I think agar hum dekhen jaise maine kaha agriculture mein farmers female farmers is the huge base, right? Aur wo undocumented hoti hain, they're all undocumented. Sadly, unki wages bhi bahut low hoti hain versus their male counterparts. So I think we came up with this idea as I talked about ke humne kaha ke ji in females ko how do we empower them? And one of the best ways could also be unko businesses set up karne ka mauka diya jaye. So we've come up with this initiative called Nazdeek, and you know the whole idea is ke in females ko opportunity mile to start their own businesses. And it's a very little investment that is actually required. There's a lot of support and encouragement from the government and various other stakeholders as well. So I think that's something that we, in our own capacity as Syngenta, we are really looking at. We are really driven to make sure that it's a national impact, national level peak impact. So that's I think that's mainly it.
And I think tapping agriculture is key because that's absolutely where predominantly the women work. And I feel kaam wo karti hai, lekin economic empowerment in terms of access to those funding, the money, the little money that they get, they don't have that decision making power.
Absolutely.
You know, so that's very, very key work you're doing on that national level. Amir.
No, I think so. मेरे ख्याल में पहली बात तो यह है कि we should all admit and agree the wave of change has started.
Yes, I agree.
And I think so. There are a lot of women now in the workforce than it was some 10 years back. 100%. So I think so. We must give some credit to ourselves, to our culture, to our society, to our country. That we are not stuck in the past. So मेरे ख्याल में थोड़ी सी हम लोग को अपने आप जरा bashing ज़्यादा करते हैं तो मेरे ख्याल में थोड़ी हमें bashing कम करनी चाहिए ठीक है and I see it at all socio-economic levels. ऐसा नहीं है. दूसरी बात यह है कि मेरे ख्याल में काफ़ी reports आती हैं जी ख़वातीन workforce में नहीं है. मेरा थोड़ा different perspective है. ख़वातीन बहुत ज़्यादा workforce में है. आप देही इलाकों में जाएँ जितनी काम कर रही हैं सारी ख़वातीन काम कर रही हैं ठीक है. आपकी जितनी बेसिकली हाउस होल्ड हेल्प है वो सब खवातीन काम कर रही है. सो खवातीन तो आपकी बेसिकली वर्कफोर्स का पार्ट है और बड़ा मेजर पार्ट है. प्रॉब्लम ये है कि वो बेसिकली इनफॉर्मल इकोनॉमी का पार्ट है. और क्योंकि फॉर्मल इकोनॉमी का पार्ट नहीं है तो उनको प्रैक्टिकली या तो अनपेड लेबर है या उनको प्रैक्टिकली फेयर वेज नहीं मिलती है. तो मेरे ख्याल में वर्कफोर्स का पार्ट बन चुकी है. किस तरह हमने उनको एक इक्विटेबल उनको वेज हमने देनी है. सो दैट्स द सेकेंड पार्ट. द थर्ड पार्ट इज एंड आई थिंक सो ये एक पैराडॉक्स है. अगर आप डेटा देखें तो 45% अगर आप अपना टर्शरी एजुकेशन देखें तो 45% जो क्लास है वो ख्वातीन की है. आप किसी भी मेडिकल कॉलेज में चले जाएं, आप किसी भी यूनिवर्सिटी में चले जाएं, 45% ख्वातीन है. मगर जब आप ADB की रिपोर्ट देखते हैं एशियन डेवलप बैंक की तो उस 45% के जो ग्रेजुएट्स होती हैं ओनली 25% एक्चुअली जॉइन द वर्कफोर्स, द रेस्ट दे डोंट. सो इट्स नॉट द एजुकेशन इज नॉट ओनली द प्रॉब्लम. आपके पास 45% एक्चुअली ग्रेजुएटिंग क्लास खवातीन है मगर वो वर्कफोर्स नहीं बने. सो यू नीड टू रियली बेसिकली क्रिएट अ कनेक्शन देयर दैट हाउ यू ट्रांसलेट इफ नॉट 100% एटलीस्ट 75% ऑफ दैट women who have actually managed to get a tertiary education, a university education to join the workforce.
Absolutely. So, okay guys, while we're really having fun and I don't want to really take a break, but I think it's time. So let's take a break and we'll resume shortly. Welcome back everybody. And I hope you guys are having as much fun in this conversation as I am. So let's continue. Great guys, I think we can have this conversation for the whole day, but we need to wrap up. There's a lot of passion and personal commitment here. But you know, just to wrap up, I would like to hear from each one of you just a one message that you would like to give. हमें बहुत सारी खवातीन भी सुन रही हैं इस वक्त, हमें बहुत सारे मर्द हजरात भी सुन रहे हैं. My personal message to all the young girls listening to us here right now would be, and this comes from the woman I am, right? This doesn't come from the advisor to the UN Secretary General or the convener of the Male Champions of Change program. This comes from the woman I am, the mother I am, the daughter I am, right? I personally and very strongly believe that while the onus of this whole women's empowerment thing, gender equality thing, agenda lies on the governments, lies on private sector leaders like yourself, lies on cultural transformations, the systemic shifts, it lies on the individual. What are you doing as a woman to really break all those glass ceilings, really break all those stereotypes, put your foot on the table and say, I'm here to make a difference. I'm here to create my space on this table. So my message to all you young women out there is to step up for yourself and create that ecosystem for yourself that you are deserving of. And trust me, the private sector will come to support you. These male leaders will come to support you. The cultural enablers will come to support you. So that's my message to all the young women watching us today. But before we leave, I would like to hear your parting messages to all our male allies listening to us.
My message to all the women listening and to the brothers and the men and everyone is mere khayal mein financial independence important hai, empowerment important hai, independence important hai, but sabse zyada jo cheez important hai wo aapki apni shanakht hai, aapki apni identity hai, theek hai, aapki apni shanakht aapke apne kaam se hone chahiye, दूसरे के काम से नहीं होनी चाहिए, दूसरे के रेफरेंस से नहीं होनी चाहिए. मेरे ख्याल में हम सब लोग पैदा किए गए हैं, हमारी अपनी एक सेल्फ एस्टीम होनी चाहिए और उसके लिए हमें कोई ना कोई काम ज़रूर करना चाहिए जिससे मेरी अपनी पर्सनल आइडेंटिटी बने, मेरी अपनी शनाख्त बने. सो मेरी रिक्वेस्ट होगी सबको कि यू नो, वी ऑल शुड बेसिकली मेक अ मार्क दिस वर्ल्ड बाय रियली प्रूविंग एंड एस्टैब्लिशिंग आवर ओन आइडेंटिटी एंड वर्क ऑन रियली हैविंग आवर ओन शनाख्त.
एब्सोल्युटली ग्रेट, 100% heartfelt.
So my message would be okay, I think it's we all know that men and women don't dream differently. Hum sab ke khwab hote hain aur mera message sab khawateen aur ladkiyon ke liye hai ki go for your dreams. Don't ever let anyone tell you that your dream is any less than what it is for a boy. Have the confidence, you can do it. I have a firm belief there is no job that a woman can't do that a man can do. That it doesn't exist. This notion is totally wrong. So go for your dreams. And for both men and women, I think my parting message would be the enablers of empathy and equity.
That's beautiful. Thank you, Umar. Thank you.
So I think for my message for all the men and women out there is ke dekhen, we are alhamdulillah blessed and we're part of a country which is a beautiful country. There are lots and lots of opportunities in Pakistan. Now it is also important to realize that we all have responsibility. We have the responsibility to give back to our country as well. And I can assure you at every single individual level, people can give back to the country. So I think that realization is very, very important. Rona, masle nikalna is very easy, but really realizing and taking the accountability and responsibility to give back to the country is the most important thing. And lastly, females ke liye mera message ye hai ki dekhen, in my own assessment is ki jitni bhi successful females across the globe, if you look at them, for me there are two factors. One is the personal commitment and second is resilience, right? So any female, so a lot of times Pakistan mein na main ye bhi dekhta hu ki wo personal commitment wala bhi element thoda sa kam ho jata hai. So I think that has to be made sure ki personal commitment is there, and of course you have to be resilient to make sure you reach the top,
right? Absolutely agree, 100% resilience. Yes,
my parting message would be, ये चीज़ मैं अपने पे भी अप्लाई करता हूँ, एंड आई माय मैसेज वुड बी टू ऑल द मेन राइट देयर, एजुकेट योरसेल्फ ऑन डाइवर्सिटी, एजुकेट योरसेल्फ ऑन द बेनिफिट्स दिस कुड ब्रिंग टू योर हाउस, द बेनिफिट्स दिस कुड ब्रिंग टू द इकोनॉमी, एंड रिमेंबर दैट एट द एंड ऑफ द डे वी ऑल आर क्रिएटेड इक्वली. सो उनको भी अपने घर में जो आपकी खवातीन हैं उनको भी अपॉर्चुनिटी दें कि वो आपकी मदद कर सकें घर में इनकम लाने के लिए, और आप उनकी मदद कर सके घर के कामों में. सो मैं भी कोशिश अपने पे अप्लाई करता हूँ कि मैं अपने आप को एजुकेट करूँ डाइवर्सिटी पे. हमने काफ़ी बात की कि उसके क्या डिफरेंट बेनिफिट्स हैं. आप एक दफ़ा एजुकेट कर लेंगे देन आपका इस पर इसकी इम्प्लीमेंटेशन पे आपकी जो बिलीफ है वो ऑफ फर्म होगा, एंड दिस वुड बी ईजियर फॉर यू.
Absolutely, absolutely. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, gentlemen. Thank you for being here and thank you for being champions of change. Thank you.
Thank you.